Hi folks, welcome back. Thought I'd come on and do a little quick one for you today. Sorry about the light, it's a bit dark in here because it's gone quite late, quite dark and dismal today. I've been asked by a lady on one of the Facebook groups I'm in how I've done this. This is like what they call faux leather. It's not finished, but what it starts off as is this. See how stiff this is? This, I'll move it all out of the way. Move it over. This one is this one. And this one seems to be better. Seems to have worked better. I've done the same method on both of them, which I'll do for you in a minute. This one seems a lot more pliable. A bit more softer, obviously. And a bit more real lifelike, I suppose. Obviously, I need to get a bit more colour going on with it, because the colour does fade when you put the wet on it and when you put the conditioner on it. If you use conditioner, hair conditioner, it does sort of disperse the ink, if you like. So that's the one. And then this one, I've done two of these. Where the other one's gone? It's flying somewhere. This one is not as soft, if you can you see? It's not as soft. I think the packaging is a bit stiffer. Can you tell? Like, that one's a bit softer and a bit thinner. Still crunchy, it's crunchy, if you know what I mean. This one's a lot harder. And it seems to have took a lot more softening. I've done this one twice and it's still quite crinkly. I've had to crinkle it up again as well. I mean, it's quite strong once you do it, you know. I mean, if you did that with sort of weathering and drip, actually, it's quite strong anyway, isn't it? But it's still good for a cover on a journal, if you get me. But I think I might need to see how the inks just spread in this, whereas when I ink them up, you'll see what they're like when I ink them up. You can re-ink them, but I don't know if they will re-ink as much now, because there's obviously conditioner on it, and I don't know if the conditioner is going to interfere with the inks. This is my other one. This is what you've got to do. You've got to like scrunch them up. This one seems a bit better colour wise. The inks, I don't know if you can see that. This one seems a bit better. I think this is the one that I've done twice. I've conditioned it twice, if you get me. So what you've got to do, basically, we'll use this little piece, just so that it's easy for me to... What you've got to do is scrunch up like this. And then the more you scrunch up, the more of these ridges you get. Excuse me. Pick it up. Ready to jump out my hand. Yeah, I've been doing it all afternoon. Can you tell? I've had to put this on top of my nice cutting mat. This is my old one. My old workhorse. So, yeah, get some scrunch going on. And then once you've got a few of these what they call little ridges and craters, get your inks. I mean, I've got a few here that I've been, the green went a bit too bright, so what you do is I've got the vintage photo first. You do that and then the ridges pick up the ink. But the best way I found to do it was like that. Because if you're pushing it up then, underneath with your finger, you see what I mean? If you do that, you're getting a lot more application, if you know what I mean. I was doing this forever and it just seemed to be mixing and not going anywhere. So do that one. Then with your darker one, I've got the espresso one here. That'll give it a bit of depth, like that. And then I'm sure there's lots of other methods. I've seen lots of different ones on YouTube. I think there's one where they use glycerin as well. That's another one. But there's a couple of videos out there. But I think it's trial and error, to be fair. You've just got to keep playing. See how that colour's mixed now. So the colour's run there because I've put it on a bit too soon. But this is the idea, if you get me. So if you wait for your ink to dry, I think it'd probably be better. It obviously wouldn't bleed as much, you know, into your paper. So then you screw it up again so it's all soft, a lot softer. I mean, it's a bit dry there, but this is like just a quick one to show you. As I did say to the lady, I'll probably do a little mini tutorial. I haven't been up to a fat lot, to be fair, guys, over the last few weeks. As you probably noticed, I've been a bit absent, as you do, you know, this lockdown, it's been tough, but we're getting there. I think numbers are coming down, hopefully all over the world, you know, that's what we want to see. See, it's quite nice now, quite soft. But I was hoping it was going to dry proper soft, but obviously it dried crinkly. So it's just like a crinkly bag, and I thought, that isn't what's happened on the videos. So I don't know if I didn't put enough conditioner on, but this one worked. So I think it could be the paper, you know, the thickness of the paper. Some of the papers aren't as forgiving, I suppose, because you're not softening the fibres enough. Because obviously this one, this thicker one, it is packaging, you know, and it is, like I did try and tear it, didn't I, for you, and it is quite strong, you know, for wrapping parcels. But I don't know what this one is. Could have been just a bag, you know, a lining off a bag, possibly, you know, like a clothes bag or something. We don't get a lot of bags in England, UK, to be fair. We get Primark bags, they're brown. But we don't get a lot of other brown packaging bags. I think Boots have started doing them, our chemist. But I don't, you know. So, what you do then is you wait for it to dry. And then when it dries, it obviously comes out like this, you know, or the other one. And then what you can do then is spread it with a thin coating of PVA, watered down PVA or watered down Mod Podge. I know it does make it go a bit shiny if you're not careful though. And it can stiffen it up, of course, as well. So the less you use, the better. But I don't think you could possibly use this on a cover of a journal without some sort of protection on it. You'd have to do something on it. I don't know how strong it is. I don't know if the conditioners know. See what I mean? And that hasn't Now this one is obviously better. It's not as, yeah, that one's better, but it's not as pliable. But I suppose it looks, I'm gonna put some more, see if we can get some more ink on it. I mean, I haven't used my dark ink pads. Well, I've got black. I think I've got like a darker brown somewhere. That the plan was to obviously use it to cover a journal. I'm going to try this side. Let's have a look, see if we can get a bit more colour going on. Because it's a shame. I did see another tutorial where they coloured it after they softened it. So that could be the best option. But there's no harm in doing it twice, I suppose. Because what the first colouring could colour the actual bag for you. You know, if you've got like a very orangey bag. Yeah, it's picking up the colour, that's fine. And obviously you'd just like leave it then to dry again. But yeah, that's what the plan is. It's supposed to look like leather, faux leather. And then you can cover your journals or make a little notebook with a mini signature in the middle or something. That's what I'll probably do with these. I'll make a few, you know, a couple of like mini notepads, I suppose you might call them. What my plan was to do an actual cover on a folder or a journal. Can you see the colouring? Can you see how it's picked it up? And that's what it's supposed to be. But I'm pretty sure, you know, I've put hand cream on this. I put hand cream on it. I thought, right, if conditioner's going to do the same, I wonder if hand cream could. You know, I thought I'll try a few different things out. If I can find some more packaging knocking about, I'll see if I can do another tutorial with, like, using different stuff that's lying around the house. I think that like castor oil or something like that, I don't know. But it's, you know, it is a bit, because I've used conditioner on it and obviously it's not been rinsed out, it is a bit not tacky, but obviously it's not dry yet, I suppose. But yeah, that's the idea anyway, guys. Right, I'll come back with another little tutorial with some more stuff when I can lay my hands on some more packaging, and I'll go and get some cream out and different things, see what I can do. Right then, guys, thanks for watching and stay safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye.